Mural painting has been a required course on the Texas Southern University's campus since the inception of the art program. There are approximately 128 murals on the campus. Texas Southern University was founded in 1947. It was already an existing institution that became Texas State College for Negroes. Now we know it as Texas Southern University. Dr. Biggers was brought to Texas Southern University in the spring of 1948. He was already established as a muralist working at Penn State, and he had heard so much about Texas. So he pretty much enjoyed the South here and saw it as an opportunity to begin to tell the story of art and the community, because he saw it as a rich, vast territory. This building was the second building on the campus, and the art program was housed on the third floor. One of the first things they did was to begin painting murals. All these murals are by students. Many of the early students were former military recruits who had come here. So some of the first murals done in the early 50s show some of that experience. You'll see the importance of becoming successful, and that success pretty much tied to education. You'll see reflections of the rural South, so you'll see cotton and other parts of the trade. As you move into the 60s and the civil rights movement begins to heat up, you begin to see some of the important figures of that civil rights struggle, including the presidents and Martin Luther King. As you get into the 70s and the 80s and the 90s, you'll see a change in color. The temperature is much warmer, hotter. You'll still see some of the earlier concepts of survival, of moving forward, of the importance of education. Religion is also very strong in these works. Kermit Oliver has two full murals as well as a few little vignettes, so he was quite prolific. You'll also see the murals of Jesse Cifuentes.
I came to Texas Southern in 1973. And the 70s was a different era. Well, the instruction was you have to paint a narrative. It has to tell a story. My mural is in a geometric form instead of the naturalistic representation. So it shows a family together. It shows a young family, and it shows also some grandparents. They're seniors, they have white hair, and they got grandchildren. When I see the murals now, I think about a history. It shows a legacy. It shows, it tells a story also. Each mural will give a different narrative of the time they were being painted.
My name is John Bullock, and I graduated in 2008. Well, it's titled They Shall Be Filled. So I just really wanted to figure out a way visually to tie in the Old and the New Testament, as well as having Jesus as this centerpiece in the communion. It definitely is a rigorous process that you gotta really figure out how to tie all the pieces together. So the biggest part for me was to spatially represent, you know, this storyline and have something that people can kind of walk through and see, you know, a narrative. And I actually intentionally used some of the same color palette from that mural and my mural, so they wouldn't compete too much and really work in harmony. I used to take breaks when I first started with just a bare white wall and a grid, and kind of look at that mural just to kind of figure out kind of how they got to their end point and visualize how we get to mine. So it, you know, was a huge inspiration just to be right next to it.
Over the years that Dr. Biggers spent at Texas Southern, He developed quite a career for himself, as well as having motivated a number of students. Before his retirement, he did the large mural, which we think is his crowning jewel, in the Sterling Student Center. That's a wonderful large mural called Family Unity that reflects his change in style as well as his interest in the African diaspora. I would say that we have quite a unique experience on this campus where you're surrounded by works that tell stories and give you the history, but do so in a beautiful, quiet way. People can learn so much from the murals, and they have appreciated them over the decades.
The murals here at Texas Southern, I think, are treasures. As a pen is to a writer, the brush is to a muralist. And murals were used as a tool, and because they're narrative, they spoke out. So I think that it gave the artist a voice.
I think there's only a few people that can really say they're a part of a legacy of over 50 years. To be a part of this, it's a huge honor. This is a gem in the city of Houston and actually in the country. There's not too many places like this.